So good morning. Previous session we discussed about series positive clipper making use of an ideal diode. So in this session we'll be discussing about a series positive clipper in case of a practical diode. So in case of an ideal diode, the cut-in voltage will be zero. It means the reference voltage will be zero. So now let me consider the diode is made up of a silicon. If it is made up of a silicon, the cut-in voltage is equals to 0.7 volts. So in this session, we'll going to plot an waveform and a mathematical representation and then the transfer characteristics of a series positive clipper in case of a practical diode. So for that, let me consider a practical diode, which is made up of a silicon, which is connected in series with the source. Let me consider this is the input voltage Vi and the V0 across the load resistance RL, and this is what your diode, a practical diode with a cut-in voltage of 0.7 volts. The same circuit can be represented like this, a source. So practical diode means an ideal diode along with a DC source. The magnitude of this DC source is equals to the cut-in voltage of the diode, that is nothing but 0.7 volts. Now this is what it just like your an ideal diode. Okay, the same circuit, the same practical clipper circuit can be represented like this. So this will place an what a cut-in voltage, the DC source. And here, since I will be getting cathode first, therefore the negative terminal of the battery first and then the anode, this is the cathode part and then anode part, minus and then plus. Okay, now in this circuit you can just observe this, the negative of the battery is connected to the anode and the magnitude of that battery is 0.7 volts. So if you want to turn on this diode, you should apply the voltage more than 0.7 volts in the reverse direction. In the reverse direction, then only the diode will get turned on. If the voltage is less than 0.7, the diode will be in the turned off position. So that's why the reference here is to analyze the circuit is a cut-in voltage 0.7. So that's why case 1, what I am going to consider is when the input voltage Vi is greater than or equals to minus 0.7. Why it is minus 0.7? So while tracing the circuit in the clockwise direction, I will be getting a negative terminal of the battery first. That's why it is a minus cut-in voltage V gamma. Yeah. So when the input voltage is greater than or equals to minus 0.7, what is the output voltage that I need to find out? What is the magnitude of the output voltage? So for that, let me write, when Vi is greater than minus 0.7, the diode will be in the off condition. If the diode is in the off condition, that should be replaced by an open switch, right? An open switch. So let me write the equivalent circuit. So this is what your open switch and the cut-in voltage, the resistance RL. So this is positive and this is what negative. When Vi is greater than or minus 0.7. So V0 is simply equals to zero because no current flows in this circuit. No current flows in this circuit. So that's why V0 is equals to zero during case 1. And during case 2 is what, when Vi is less than or equals to minus 0.7, what is the value of V0? That is what I need to find out. So for that, when the input voltage is less than or equals to minus 0.7, that is the condition where the diode gets turned on, right? Because from this circuit, I can easily say that during negative off cycle, the diode gets turned on, not in the positive cycle, negative off cycle. Negative in the sense it should be less than, right? Less than or equals to minus 0.7. So this is the source, and during when the input voltage is less than minus 0.7, the diode will get turned on. So that is represented by closed switch, and there is a cut-in voltage of V gamma, that is 0.7 volts. Then the resistance, so Vi, this is what your RL. So this Vi opposes this cut-in voltage, because both are connected. In during negative off cycle, this will be positive and this will be negative, right? And for example, let me write this. Here I have a resistance. Again, this is positive, this is negative. You can just observe this. If this is V gamma and this is VI, these two are opposing in nature, right? So that's why the V naught is equal to, during negative off cycle, the current is flowing in this counterclockwise direction due to this source VI. So minus VI because of negative direction plus 0.7 volts, because this cut-in voltage always opposes this input voltage, right? So simply it is minus VI plus 0.7 when during a negative off cycle. So together, from mathematical expression 1 and then expression 2, when VI is greater than or equals to minus 0.7, V naught equals 0 volts. Then when VI is less than or equals to minus 0.7, V naught equals VI plus 0.7. This is the mathematical representation of what? A series positive clipper. So let me write the waveform for this. Okay, let me write the waveform for this. So this is what an input signal, where the peak of the signal is Vm, and this is what your negative peak minus Vm. Okay, and this is what your input signal. So what is the reference here? The reference is V gamma equals 0.7 volts, right? So while tracing this circuit, I'll be getting negative terminal first. It means the reference is what? Minus 0.7. The reference is what? Minus 0.7, right? So this is 0, this is pi, 2 pi, okay? So let me write the output waveform for this. So here we'll be having two cases, where the input is greater than minus 0.7. This is minus 0.7. So it means from origin to this point, this is the case 1. This is what? Case 2. During case 1, when the input voltage is more than minus 0.7, the output voltage is simply equals to 0, right? And when the input voltage is more negative than this minus 0.7, it just, you are going to get the output, that is VI equals minus 0.7. So since this is minus Vm, as we already said, so plus 0.7, the peak of this is minus Vm plus 0.7. Again, during negative off cycle, the V naught is equals to 0. This is whatever V naught waveform. Clear? So we can also write the transfer characteristics for this. So for the transfer characteristics, this is VI, this is V naught, and as we already said, the reference is minus 0.7. Somewhere here it is minus 0.7. So when the input voltage is greater than minus 0.7, it means output is 0, and for here it will be like this. It is linear. So here the diode will be in the on condition, here the diode will be in the off condition. This is what your transfer characteristics, the waveform, and then mathematical expression of a practical diode. Here, remember, in case of practical diode, the reference voltage will be the cut-in voltage will be the reference in order to decide whether the diode is in the on position or in the off position. That's why here I'm not going to consider during positive off cycle, during negative off cycle. Instead of that, I will be considering when the input voltage is more than or equals to minus 0.7 volts. It means the cut-in voltage. And in case 2, when the input voltage is less than or equals to minus 0.7 volts. Okay, thank you.